Hello and good afternoon and welcome to a new tutorial. I'm going to show you how to do Tunisian crochet. Tunisian crochet is a little bit different than normal crochet, and I think most of you have seen this kind of hook. They are also called an Afghan hook. They are really long with a knob at the end and a normal hook on the other end. They are mostly about 17 inches long, and well, I'm going to show you what to do with these kind of hooks. And this is already something I made for the Dutch tutorial. Today I'm going to show you how to make a foundation row, and I'm going to show you how to do the Tunisian simple stitch. Then you will get these kind of blocks and really a very sturdy crochet swatch. So I'm just going to show you. Maybe you have already seen it, but I also got a learn to crochet Tunisian style course on my blog, and I thought it would be wise to add video tutorials to it, because sometimes you just have to see it to get it. So I'm just going to show you what to do with an Afghan hook. First of all, if you're going to crochet with an Afghan hook, please pick a size larger than you're normally would use for your yarn. I have Drops Paris here, which is for size G or 4 millimeter. If you're going to pick 4 millimeter Afghan hook for this yarn, it will be too tight. It will curl. You really have to create loose stitches with Tunisian crochet. So right now I'm going to use a Susan Bates 5 millimeter hook, and I already made a slip knot. And first of all, I'm going to make a chain with chain stitches. So this is regular crochet. I'm going to do 15 chains. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, and 15. What I'm now going to do is make a foundation row for Tunisian crochet. So I'm going to pick up loops, that is why you have such a long hook, and make a forward pass and then a return pass to work all the loops from my hook. So the foundation row starts as follows. You insert in the second stitch from hook, which is this one. You're going to make a yarn over and pull through and keep the loop on the hook. And this is what I'm going to do for all my stitches on my chain. So insert, yarn over, pull through. Insert. So until I get to the last stitch. This is a bit a tricky part, it will get easier. And you should get the same amount of loops as the amount of chain stitches you started in your foundation chain. So in the end I will have 15 loops on my hook as I chained 15 stitches, chain stitches. So okay. my last. And as you can see, I have all of these loops on my hook, and I have 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, and 15 stitches on my hook, as it should be. This is my foundation row forward pass. So now I have to go backwards. This is going to be my return pass, but at the start of a return pass you always have to chain one to get a bit of height to your stitches. So this is my chain one. And the return pass is yarn over and pull through two loops. So yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, pull through two loops, yarn over, pull through. And in this is the way to work all of those loops from your Afghan hook. So I'm just going to work my return pass, and I'm going to show you how to do the Tunisian simple stitch. The foundation row is for all Tunisian crochet. It's just the same principle. So right now I have this. Bit boxy. And now I'm going to do the Tunisian simple stitch. So you take your row. I'm going to do a forward pass, and I'm going to insert behind the front loop of my first stitch. Then I'm going to do yarn over and pull through and leave the loop on my hook. Only underneath the front loop, yarn over, pull through. Front loop, yarn over, and pull through. And this you will do for all of your stitches until you get to the last stitch. And I'm just going to show you how to do the last stitch, because that last stitch needs a bit more attention. So and this is my second to last, and here is my last stitch. The last stitch is a bit tricky. You need to work in the chain, actually the chain one stitch you just made. You can see it as a stair step. This is the part you step on, and this is the part of this stair step that you used to get height. So I'm going to insert in the vertical loop, and there you have it. Just counting 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, and 15. So I'm back to my previous amount of stitches. Now I'm going to do a chain 1 for my return pass. And then I'm going to work all my loops off of my hook. So yarn over, pull through 2, yarn over, pull through 2, and I'm going to get them all off. So and this was my first row of the Tunisian simple stitch. And as you can see, I get vertical loops here and a little of a braid-like stitch here. And with the Tunisian simple stitches, there's a forward pass and then putting them on the behind the front loop. Work all your loops on your hook until you get to the end. Make a chain one and I'll work all of your loops from your hook with a yarn over and pull through two. So I'm just going to show you a few more. So behind the vertical one, pull loop up. So, and you'll see, I'll show you here underneath, you will get a nice sturdy bit of Tunisian crochet. So this is how you do it. This was the Tunisian simple stitch and the foundation row. I really hope you liked it. The other Tunisian stitches will be coming in the next few weeks. And if you are curious, you can also check out my Learn to Crochet Tunisian Style course and have a look at all the other projects I have been making with Tunisian crochet. So it's bye bye from me, and hopefully see you next week.